Hello everyone, so today I'm going to show you my July setup, which is a bit late this time since I didn't have a lot of time to film and edit this month, but I hope you enjoy it nevertheless, so let's get into it. I was super inspired by so many beautiful ocean setups last month, so I wanted to paint a wave with like a beach from this top perspective, as you can see, with all those like swirls of color. And I'm also using colored inks again because I had a lot of fun using them last time, so I wanted to try them again. And I also have this little dish to mix my inks in, and of course some watercolor paper. This one is 200 GSM, it has a really nice texture, and it's also secured on all the sides, so I just left it on the block to paint. I just quickly wanted to show you the colors that I'm going to be using today. So for the light part of the waves, I'm using cyan blue, turquoise, and phthalo blue, and then for the really dark parts, I'm going to be using indigo. For the beach part, I'm going to be mixing some magenta with a bit of umbra and some yellow tones, so either ochre or golden yellow. So then I just got myself some water to dilute the inks, and of course I also have some brushes. I ended up only using those round brushes. And then I started with the beach section, so here I'm mixing up this kind of peachy reddish tone. I'm using quite a bit of water so that it's less intense. And then I'm just making a rough shape of where I want the beach to be based on my sketch. I'm also laying down a lot of water so that I can create a gradient easily. So here I'm just darkening the edge towards the water because the sand would be a bit wet from the waves and then it would be darker there. Next up, I'm using those three lighter blue shades for the waves in the middle part, and I changed my water quickly, but as you can see, I still had a little bit of ink in my brush, which doesn't really matter since it would get covered up anyway. But yeah, I'm again using a lot of water because I really want to get that effect where the paint just kind of goes wherever it wants to, and I just really love it when the paint spreads out like that. I think it's something that you can't really get with acrylics, for example. So yeah, as you can see, I'm just kind of going in layers. I'm not really letting things dry in between, just kind of putting down more color wherever I feel like it. And then for the dark parts, like I mentioned before, I'm using indigo, which is a really deep kind of reddish blue tone, and I'm just kind of letting it bleed into those other blues. I really didn't want any like clean edges because obviously water just kind of flows into each other, and honestly to me it's just super calming to watch the colors like bleed and blend. Definitely would recommend. And yeah, then I'm just slowly adding more and more layers. The inks do tend to dry a little bit lighter because I'm using a lot of water, so I had to build up kind of the contrast step by step. Later on, I'm also going to be using some white gouache for kind of the foamy parts of the wave. But yeah, there's not really a lot to talk about here. I'm just going back and forth, wetting the paper and putting down more colors, letting it dry, and then kind of repeating the process. So yeah, I guess just enjoy this time lapse. Thank you. Alright, so here's where I'm using the white gouache, and I'm starting at the edge between the water and the sand. I just wanted it to be a bit more irregular, and then I'm slowly going into the foamy parts. And as you can see, I'm making like kind of wavy lines to show like the movement of the water. It's kind of hard to explain, but I just tried to add more detail by using the brush with more paint and very little water. So that way it kind of shows the rougher texture of the paper, like it kind of gets stuck in those little crevices. And I think that just gives it this very like detailed look. Usually the foam is not super white if you look at references, and there's a lot of water peeking through here and there, so I thought it worked really well. Honestly, I was actually super scared to just go in with the paint because I was super happy with the inks, but it ended up working really well, so I'm happy about that. Once everything was completely dry, I'm using a sharp knife to go along the edges of the paper and to kind of cut it off the block. And please do be careful if you do this. And yeah, this is the finished painting. I really enjoyed the process. It was a lot more relaxing than other paintings I've done, just because it's kind of like an abstract painting in a way. And as always, I took a photo and edited it a bit for the print, and then I wanted to see how I'm gonna do the title, so I just tried out a bunch of stuff in Procreate. I did try it in the bottom left corner, but I didn't really like that, so I ended up going with the top upper corner. I just wrote it in this very simple, like, wavy font. But yeah, I didn't print it out with the title, I just kind of wanted to try it out first, and then I'm gonna write it on the actual print with a gel pen. Of course, I printed out the painting and some stickers as always. I think the colors turned out really good this time. So yeah, here's the stickers. I have some circles, large ones and small ones, and then also some rectangles for like headers and stuff. And yeah, let's get into the actual planning portion of this video. I first rounded off two of the corners of my painting, and then I put it on the right page. And then I'm using the Univol Signal white gel pen to write the title like I sketched it out before. On the left page, I used one of the large circle stickers and added a mini calendar underneath. I'm gonna be decorating mostly with 4 different colors. So I have a light blue, a really dark blue, a kind of peachy pink, and a light like orangish yellow. So yeah, I also added a lot of these wavy lines. You're gonna see a lot more of that later on. And this setup was definitely a lot more like bold and different from what I usually go for, but I ended up really liking the finished spread. So yeah, I hope you do too. I just added a couple of borders all around the page. I used these 2 different blue shades and the other 2 shades that I mentioned, and yeah, I just kind of wanted to match it to the painting, so like the sand and the water colors. So yeah, that's my very simple cover page. And then moving on, I changed things up a little bit here. So I'm starting with my habit trackers this time, which I kind of wanted to place around the sticker, just because I wanted to try something new. Honestly, I'm not super sure if that was the best idea, but you live and you learn, I guess. I used the light pink and the yellow for the calendar shape and the weekdays. And if you've never seen how I do my habit trackers, I just kind of trace the shape of the calendar and then I can just fill out every day with a color. Then I used the dark blue to write the habits, but ended up changing that later on, so just ignore that part. And then I also put the sticker into the middle, which I also changed later on, so yeah, definitely some trial and error here, but it worked out in the end. Then I also decorated the kind of empty spaces with more of those wavy lines, just to kind of keep it cohesive. And then underneath the habits, I added 2 simple sections just for my YouTube and Instagram growth trackers. And then all the way at the bottom, I wanted to write a quote that says, "Everything comes in waves." Obviously very fitting, but I also changed this part a bit. But anyway, on the other page, I'm again trying something new, and I just split it into 2 sections. One is for my study goals. So for me, that's learning Korean and art. I just wanted to have a space to kind of track my progress. So yeah, and then on the bottom part, this is just some space for me to plan my Instagram posts, because I haven't posted anything in so long. And I do want to share more of my bullet journal and art stuff with you guys. So yeah, hopefully this will help a bit. So then here's what I mentioned before. I just covered up the titles of my habits with this thin like black washi tape that I have. I just felt like the page needed a bit more contrast, and I think it works a lot better now. Then I also removed the sticker and just replaced it with a smaller one. I just felt like it was a bit too much. And then for the quote, I just didn't really like the waves part, so I covered it with another sticker and just wrote it in white instead. On the right page, I also added more borders in this kind of wavy style, and I think that made it all a bit more cohesive. So then lastly, let's move on to my first weekly spread of July. I wanted to keep it pretty simple, so I'm just doing a layout that I have been loving recently, which is just these vertical boxes for each day that are on different heights. You'll see what I mean in a bit. But yeah, again, I added a mini calendar on the top left, and then I created my daily sections. I'm just alternating the pink and the yellow for the weekdays, and then also doing those wavy borders on all of them with the blue, which I ended up making them just as thick as the other ones I made before. Thank you. Then I used 2 stickers and some doodles just to kind of decorate the empty spaces on the bottom right and the top left. And then I also made 2 more sections for my weekly hydration tracker and just for some random notes. And yeah, here I'm making the lines a bit thicker, and that's about it. Honestly, like I mentioned before, this one was quite a bit different than what I usually go for, as in it's like a lot more bold in the colors and everything, but I do really like it. It feels very summery to me, so that's fitting. And yeah, I hope you like it too. And before the video ends, I just wanted to say a huge, huge thank you for 700 subscribers. I haven't been able to thank you guys properly, but it really means a lot. But yeah, that's it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed painting and planning with me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!